The United States recently had its credit rating downgraded. It's a decision that could have sprawling financial impacts on the average American. But rather than working to fix the problem, both Democrats and Republicans are blaming each other for the downgrade. I have Ring of Fire's Farron Cousins joined me, probably the best, absolutely the best progressive commentator in the business. That's what I think of you. I actually think you are the best commentator in this business.
That means a lot. Thank you.
So I want to know what your take is on this. I see it looks like a food fight, doesn't it? Fitch says, look, we haven't downgraded you. Biden is, it's like musical chairs. Biden is the guy that's in charge when this happens. He's, you know, and all of a sudden the Democrats say, no, this was Trump. This happened because of January 6th, 2.5 years ago. And understand, they do these ratings like quarterly.
Yeah.
So if it would have been January 6th, I think they would downgrade it by now. Let's talk about it, though.
It is funny because, you know, when this happened, you know, all the liberal sites I check, they all say, look at this, Republicans, it's January 6th. They're responsible for this. They're, you know, attempted shutdown of the government. It did this. You look at the conservative media sites. Oh, look what the Democrats have done with the spending, the out of control spending. So both sides have said, it's not us. It's these guys.
But let's go to what they said. Let's go to what Fitch said. I mean, let's and talk about it. Fitch said, look, it is, they made a list, and it is spending. Fitch is one of the big three credit ratings. Yeah. It's an important story. They expected fiscal deterioration over the next several years. That was in there. High government deficit burden because of crazy spending. And that's Republicans and Democrats spending like damn drunk sailors on a weekend. You can't say that was just Democrats. Republicans had to vote for it too. They had the right to stop it if they didn't want to do it. Last minute resolutions on debt limits, yeah. Children in a food fight. Oh, well, you know, let's wait till the last minute to see if we still are in business. And deterioration of governance. But, you know, deterioration of governance is pretty evident. They can't even be in a room without, like, being children, fighting over nothing. Everything's so tribal and divided. Fitch looks at it and says, my God, who is, it looks like Home Alone. We're not interested in the Home Alone series, right?
Well, and I think, you know, it may be the last thing on the list, but I really think that is the most important because that is the one that represents the worst trend that we see right now in politics. It is almost impossible for Democrats to get Republicans to go along with their legislation or Republicans to get Democrats to go. Nobody wants to work with the other side because it has become more tribal. And you and I have been doing this for over 20 years. We haven't seen it like this. During the Bush years, we did not have this much of a divide in Congress.
You know what I think is funny? We have comments that come through our staff. Our staff shows us a comment every now and then. And the comment is, You got me and they got you. Now, first of all, we're friends. We disagree with a lot of things, but we don't yell at each other. We respect each other. And the people can't stand that. When I say something that might sound middle of the road, they say, by God, Farron, why didn't you jump in there and, you know, beat him up? Because that's not how it ought to go. We ought to be able to carry on a conversation. But these numbnuts, these, you know, I don't know how else to describe it. Absolute numbnuts believe that everything has to be conflict. And that's what you're saying, isn't it? You're saying that in politics, that's where we are right now. And Fitch said, that's dysfunctional. That's a lack of governance, along with the fact that you're wasteful spending, along with the fact that you have $10 trillion in new spending, along with the fact you're buying bombs for Ukraine like it's yesterday, you know, like you've gone crazy. We're just in this situation where Fitch looks at the whole picture and says, this scares the hell out of us, and we're going to downgrade you.
Yeah, and, you know, about that whole the tribalism thing, we've always seen that with the public. You know, it's something you and I have had dealt with, you know, the whole time we've been doing this. But this is really one of the first times we've seen it this bad in Congress. And that's where it becomes this really big problem. And people have to understand, when our credit rating gets downgraded as a country, that means other countries are not going to want to buy up our debt. It could drive up our interest rates, pricing you out of buying a car or a house or even a refrigerator. This will impact not the people in D.C. causing it. This will impact you. And you, the consumer, you, the voter, at some point you have to look at the decisions you're making every time you step in that polling booth And I've been saying this a lot recently, but y'all have to take responsibility for what you're
voting for. Oh, absolutely. The other part of the responsibility is to don't dare send a comment to this site and say, Pap, why didn't you jump on Farron about this? Farron, why didn't you jump on my... Because we're not friggin' children. Because we can think... We don't think like a five-year-old. That's why we don't do that. But unfortunately, the general public, it's all tribal. Oh, my God, he said this. Why didn't you beat the hell out of him about it? That's the mentality out there right now. Yeah. And it's all a reflection of what's happening in Washington. And Fitch sees it, and it scares the hell out of Fitch. Yeah.